I found a cassette that we were kind of putting on hard drives to save them. The guy that was doing it, he said, do you realize that you wrote Jolene and I Will Always Love You at the same time? I said, no, I did not realize that, because I write so many things. Very possible that I wrote them both the same day, if not that same week, I'm sure. Hi, this is Dolly Parton, and today I'm going to break down some of my iconic albums. Hello, I'm Dolly, from 1967. A start, a chance, and a hope. This was my very first album, so of course I was very excited about that. I was on Monument Records at the time, and a man named Fred Foster had taken interest in me. So this was the beginning of my career in country music as far as a true artist and a true singer-writer. I believe that was Fred Foster that came up with that. Hello, Dolly was big on Broadway at the time and had just come out, and my name's really Dolly. And so he said, well, why don't we call it Hello, I'm Dolly? And that was just a natural. If I was doing another album of songs from back then, I might call it Hello, I'm Still Dolly. Fred Foster took that picture as well, I believe. In fact, that was before I started wearing wigs and falls. That was kind of my own hair. I remember he had me out in the sunlight, and he said, well, let's just do it outside because you're a country girl. Let's just do it. So that's what we did. I suppose I was thinking on that album cover, the sun is in my eyes and I'll be glad when they get this picture taken, and I hope they get a good one. But actually during that whole shoot, we were outside and it was pretty, but I remember just thinking that I was so happy and proud that I was finally getting to do my first album that had been a dream of mine all my life. Dumb Blonde, that was my first big chart record. That was in the top 10. It really kind of sums me up, even to this day. I hope so. It's called Just Because I'm Blonde, Don't Think I'm Dumb. 'Cause this dumb blonde ain't nobody's fool. And it was that record that actually got the attention of Porter Wagoner, and he had asked me to come be the girl singer on that show, and it was that very song that kind of started it out. This is Coat of Many Colors, 1971. Personal, loving, caring. Well, at the time, we chose the title for the album because that song became such a big hit worldwide. Everybody related to that little song one way or another. Even if you had been bullied, if you didn't have clothes to wear, it was about being made fun of. And I got so many letters and responses from people saying how that song had kind of healed them of some hurt that they had. So I thought, well, we just have to call the album that because this song has touched the lives of so many people. And anytime you have a big hit, usually you'll do an album of that particular song or titled that. That little photograph is me, and that is my little coat of many colors. I think they kind of colored it a little more brighter for the cover, but that was me. And on the back, it was all, you know, different patches and all, but that was different strips of rags that Mama had put together to make a little coat for me. And thank goodness I had a picture of that to make an album cover from. The Coat of Many Colors is a song that's dear to me. And of course, the little coat of many colors is a true story from my childhood. I didn't even know that I had been hurt that bad about the whole experience of the kids laughing at me and all, but it just started coming out one day, and it just turned into a song that was meant to be because it has touched the lives, as I mentioned, of so many people. They made it into a little book that they even teach in school about bullying and differences and how to accept one another for our differences. And of course, we made it into a TV movie. So Mama knew what she was doing when she told me to make me proud of it, about the story from the Bible of Joseph and the coat of many colors. My Tennessee Mountain Home, 1973. It's personal, it's heartfelt, it's emotional. the things I had done before as albums, before the Tennessee Mountain Home, had been different songs, different styles, but this one, I wanted to tailor make it. It was a theme album. And I remember kind of having to argue about it. I said, I really need to do this. Right now, I'm beginning to be everything that I dreamed of being. And it was those dreams back there on that little porch in that little cabin with that tobacco stick and that crack in the floor and a tin can for a microphone that I dreamed of all this. The cover of that album is my old Tennessee mountain home. That's up in East Tennessee at the foothills of the Smokies, and we moved out of it long, long ago, but I bought it back, and I took that whole place, kind of turned it into like a movie set, really, but that was the real house. I did my Tennessee mountain home, and that is one of my personal favorites because I really did get to write about all those things, like Mama's old kettle and Daddy's working boots and all the things that I remembered growing up, and getting to talk about all those things. Even the song Tennessee Mountain Home really kind of just leads you right through from the schoolhouse to the church house to our house to the neighbors, all that. So I really thought that it was personal, and it was needed, and it was a theme, and I was happy to do it. It's like a TV show that has different stories each week. So each song kind of leads you through my childhood. And so I'm as proud of that as anything I've ever done. Jolene, 1974. I think it's meaningful, insightful, and I'd like to think creative. Well, that little song has become the favorite of so many people. I had no idea when I wrote it that it was going to be as big as it was. And I tell the story about Jolene. My husband got a crush on this beautiful, red-headed, long-legged girl down at the bank. And I knew we didn't have the kind of money for him to be spending that kind of time at the bank. And so I tell the story about how I went down there one day. He was sitting talking to this girl, and I said, what you doing? He said, I'm trying to get a loan. Because he was in the asphalt paving business. I said, you need to get your ass home, or it's going to be your ass and your fault. So I kind of tell this joke on stage about it. Well, I remember that we spent a long day shooting that cover, and I was glad that that was a jumpsuit that was kind of stretchy. I think that was made by a woman named Lucy Adams or Ruth Kemp. There were two women that did my clothes at that time, and I don't remember which one, but that's okay. We'll give them both credit. Their kids will love it. Anyhow, it was a good little cozy outfit, easy to sit in, easy to stand in, and I was doing all sorts of poses that day. So I just remember sitting down with that little jumpsuit on. I don't even know if they was posing me for that. I probably was just taking a rest. They snapped a picture, and there it is. And then I had that big old hairdo. My Aunt Colleen Owens did. She was big on the big hair, and I was big right there with her on it. So anyhow, I think that's a fun cover, and it kind of summed me up for that time. Actually, the name Jolene, her name wasn't Jolene. I did get that name from a little girl that I was signing autographs for. I'd never heard that name before. I remember signing the name Jolene, and I said, that's a beautiful name. I'm going to write a song about that. I said, if you ever hear a song about that, you'll know I wrote it about you. So I just kept thinking, Jolene, Jolene. And that's how that rhythm, you know, like Jolene, Jolene. I didn't want to forget it till I got back to the bus. So I was going, Jolene, 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 Jolene. And all of a sudden it just became Jolene, 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 Jolene. And I thought, well, there's a chorus right there. So I just kind of made it into a song, and then I made up those verses. I love little minor chords, and I just started picking and hitting that little lick, and it started sounding better and better. And I thought, well, this is a really clever little thing. I mean, I'm enjoying playing it, and I'm enjoying how this is sounding. And I think, because it is so simple, you know, the Jolene, 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 and the fact that it's in a minor key is kind of mysterious, too, makes it kind of haunting-like. But everybody loves that song. of all the songs that I've written in my life, that's the one that's been most recorded. Well, I'm always excited when anybody records any of my songs, but Jolene, I mean, so many people have done that song. Miley Cyrus does it in her stage show. I know White Stripes, they do it on their show. They did it in an album. I know Keith Urban sings it on stage all the time. Everywhere you go, somebody's singing Jolene, and I just love that. I sing it a lot, too. Here You Come Again, 1977. Oh, exciting, refreshing pop. Here You Come Again was a song that was brought to me because I had just left the Porter Wagoner show. I was going out on my own. A lot of people were saying I was making a big mistake, that I was leaving country. I always said, I'm not leaving country. I'll always take country with me wherever I go. But they said, you can't leave the Porter Show. You can't go trying to run after stardom and pop. You're a big country artist. And I said, yeah, but I can't just stay in one place all the time. So I just got with all these wonderful people and found this wonderful song written by Cynthia Wild and Barry Mann, who've written great songs like You've Lost That Loving Feeling. And they were great writers. So of course, we had to do an album. That was my first million-selling record, too, by the way. I didn't want to totally leave country. I didn't want to, like, try to be something I wasn't, so we thought probably best to kind of keep the country look with the blue jeans and the little shirt, but to kind of make it a little more like pop art, sort of. I had a little more shorter hair, trying to be a little more up-to-date, I guess. A little more Hollywood-y, Dollywood-y kind of look. Fredericks of Dollywood, I guess. But anyhow, it seemed to work. 9 to 5 and Odd Jobs, 1980. Busy, complicated, and fun. We felt like we really needed to cover all the different jobs that people do, because there's so many people out there that not only work 9 to 5, they work 5 to 9 or whatever. It was more just about the working people in the world. And I didn't want to just do songs about just women in the workplace, because we did that with the 9 to 5 song. And of course, we did other songs in this album that didn't relate to that. But it was as much about all the different people, the men and the women that working in different departments, doing different things all over the country. All those morning jobs where everybody gets up and stumbles to the kitchen and pours a cup of ambition. This one, when we did The Odd Jobs, was the one that was complicated because we were trying to figure out how to do an album cover that covered everybody's job. We kind of gathered up every piece of equipment you could have. I felt like the village people kind of doing it. I just remember that day having to haul that stuff around and putting all the stuff on me, you know, to try to make this great picture and then try to stand exactly right. But I just remember we had so much fun laughing about all the different odd jobs. Should we use a plunger? Should we use, nah, that wouldn't look good in the picture, or, you know, that kind of stuff. So it was a fun day. It was a fun photo shoot. White Limousine, 1989. It was meaningful, and it was also playful. It was also creative. I'm the one that came up, I think, with the spelling it weird. It could have been Mac. We're very similar. I probably didn't even know how to spell limousine, so that's probably how I wrote it down when I was writing it. So it's very possible. Somebody said, well, you wrote it down like that. Is that what you want to call it? I just thought White Limousine was a perfect, clever little thing. And now they've got a restaurant called White Limousine and spelling it the same way. So, worked. We, of course, thought it's about a girl going to Hollywood, dreaming of being a star. So the cover of that album is one of my favorite covers, actually. So we thought, well, this should be like a Hollywood premiere, should be in front of a marquee with a movie, you know, as if it was like a movie. Me coming out of a white limousine in my fancy, fancy clothes, like a big premiere. So that was one of the fun shoots that I've ever done on an album. And we actually did it in California. I wrote that song with Mac Davis, and we were trying to write something that kind of like a Daisy May kind of song, like Daisy May in Hollywood was one of our songs. We were wanting to write something that kind of took me out of like the country into Hollywood. It was more just about a country girl with her big dreams. Rather than going to Nashville, she was going to Hollywood. So she was dreaming about a big white limousine, and if she made it, she's going to go back, take all her family, which I did. We kind of based it on my life. But it was just a fun song to write because Mac Davis and I write so good. He's one of the greatest writers in the world. We're both country people. We both have a crazy sense of humor. So when we do write together, we have a lot of fun doing it. But we also try to come up with stuff, you know, that's really fitting. And this was really one that I was really proud of. A Holly Dolly Christmas 2020. Joyful, jolly, fun. I always loved the song Holly Jolly Christmas. I loved Burl Ives, and he had the big record on that, and I'd done a few Christmas specials with him through the years. And when I got ready to do this Christmas album, which I thought it was time, the last one I did was 30 years ago, I thought, well, what will I call a Christmas album? There's so many titles. I could have done A Dolly for Christmas or Deck the Halls with Boughs of Dolly, and I thought, no! I'm going to record Holly Jolly Christmas because I love that song. So I will call the album A Holly Dolly Christmas. It just seemed to fit so good. And I thought, yay, that's a perfect title for this little album. I love the cover of this album. Steve Summers designed this outfit. I wanted Holly on it, but I didn't want it to be overdone. So he made like little holly earrings and made this beautiful little dress and just the little pieces of holly I thought were in good taste. I love red. My mother, that was her favorite color, and I love Christmas. So I thought that was a good one. I think it's some of the best work I've ever done. I did 6 duets on the album. I'm excited about that. I got Jimmy Fallon, I've got Willie Nelson, I've got Billy Ray Cyrus, I got Miley Cyrus, and of course, Michael Bublé. We did Cuddle Up Cozy Down Christmas. It's a song I wrote, and oh, he killed it. Everybody loves him. I love him too, and I think it turned out so good. I did a wonderful song that's destined to be a major Christmas classic called Mary Did You Know? I also did a song called Christmas Is. The one with Miley Cyrus is from the Christmas on the Square musical that I wrote all the music for. I think it's a good album. I think everybody will enjoy it. I talk a lot, and so it's kind of like I'm kind of in your house for Christmas. I hope you'll love that. If not, kick me out. Play the music anyway. Coat of Many Colors is my personal favorite. I think Coat of Many Colors kind of is so much more than just a song. It's about, well, the love of family, of course, and a good mother, in my case, blessed with that. But it's also about acceptance. It's just about home. It's about family. It's spiritual. A song that has a lot of lessons in it. In fact, they even teach it from some of the grammar schools about acceptance. I really felt like that little song was blessed, and God gave that to me to share with the world, because a lot of people say that they've been inspired or healed from things that they've gone through where they've been made fun of. So I really think that one is my favorite because of so many reasons.
With love, she made my coat of many colors that I was so proud.